B'shut Moreh Rabotei, with the permission of Hashem, today it's the Parsha of Matan Torah, and Be'ezat Hashem, next week, is the Parsha of Elei HaMishpatim. What the meaning of Elei HaMishpatim? After that Hashem, He gives the Torah, so Hashem, He said now to the Bnei Yisrael, this is the law. It's like, on Matan Torah, it was an introduction. Usually when you buy a book, you have the book, introduction of the book, and then you read the book. So Matan Torah was the introduction for the Torah. Hashem, he presented himself, Ani Hashem, Anuchi Hashem Elokecha, Am Hashem, who give you the liberation from Egypt. That was the introduction. Now, Elei HaMishpatim, this is the laws that Hashem, He gives to the Bnei Israel to do. But first, before we try to understand a little bit Elei HaMishpatim, Rashi said, Elei HaMishpatim, this is the laws. Hashem, He said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe, you must explain the mitzvot to Am Yisrael like a Shulchan Aruch. Usually when you invite somebody, you put everything, you know, next to the guests, because usually the guests, you know, they are a little bit embarrassing. So you put bread next to them, salads next to them. They have the knives, the forks, that they don't need to ask. Do you have this? Do you have this? You know, Hashem is to Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe, you must teach the Bnei Israel Torah in a way that they don't have any question. But I have to tell you something incredible. You know, we are in this world like a guest. You understand? We are like a guest. There is nobody who will live forever. We are a guest. That's it. You know the Chafetz Chaim Alav HaShalom? He had always a suitcase next to the door. So when they asked him, why you have a suitcase next to the door? He told them, that suitcase reminded me that I am only a guest here. When somebody travels somewhere, he don't take with him all his furniture of the house. He take only one suitcase. Because he's not going to stay there forever. When he knows that when he goes only for 1 week, 2 weeks, he come back. So the Chafetz Chaim said, this suitcase remind me that I am a guest here. I'm not forever here. That's it. And I think that why a lot of times we said that the Torah about Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov, when we talk about them, we mention that they were only a guest. Kiger, Kiger Anuchi Imcha, Ger V'Toshav. I'm here only as a stranger. My friend, we in this world, we are the guest. We are not the Baal HaBayit. Ki li kol ha'aretz, the Parashat said in the Yitro. Parashat Yitro said that Hashem said, Ki li kol ha'aretz, all the land is mine. There is nothing yours. So what do you do in my land? You are my guest. That's it. So because when we have a guest, we must prepare him everything next to him. So Hashem, He said to the Bnei Israel, because they are guests in this world, so you need food. Like when somebody invites you, he doesn't invite you just to stay home, he invites you for dinner. I mean, this is so you need food. There is two kinds of food. There is food that you eat, and there is food, its name is Torah. The same way that you cannot live without food, it's the same. You cannot live without the Torah. You cannot live the Torah. And that way, Hashem is saying to Moshe Rabbeinu, right away, after the Matan Torah, after that, and after that Hashem, and introduce himself, said, right away, Hashem, he said to Moshe Rabbeinu, now that they know who I am, so serve them the spiritual food, and put it the spiritual food in a table, like that the table, there is everything full of, that they will not need to ask something, they have everything on the table. I would like to tell you something that is very, very important. The first mitzvah that Hashem gives to the Bnei Israel after his introduction, that he is the Baal HaBayit, Ki Li Kol HaAretz, the land is mine, I'm the one who, the Ten Commandments, it said, Hashem, when he presented himself, he said, Anuchi Hashem, Eluk Hashem, Tzitzicha, Meretz Mitzrayim, Mit Avadim. I'm Hashem that led you out from Egypt. They give you the liberty, the exit of Egypt, it's me. Anuchi, and then Hashem will give them the Ten Commandments. There is something incredible in this parasha. Before that Hashem gives them, he presents himself to them, the question is, but everybody knows who is Hashem. Why Hashem he needed to do this kind of introduction? Anuchi Hashem Elokecha, I am. I mean, they don't need that Hashem will tell them, I am. We know that Hashem is the one who invites them now around the mountain of Sinai to give them the Torah. They know. During 1 year, Hashem was doing miracles. So, what do you mean this kind of introduction? Just imagine. In America, after the election of President Biden, I mean, for his first speech, he would tell them, I am Biden. I mean, hey. Everybody voted for you. I mean, we know who you are. What this kind of introduction? Just imagine, Baruch Hashem, I go to a synagogue to give a speech, and everybody comes to hear me, and I tell them, you know, my friend, I am David Pinto, who invited you to come for this speech. Of course they know. Everybody knows. So why Hashem, he had to tell them, Anuchi Hashem, why this kind of introduction? I mean, okay, you can introduce yourself if nobody knows you. Yes, but if everybody knows you, why you need this kind of introduction? My friend, I was thinking that kind of introduction of Hashem toward the Bnei Israel was spectacular, as you will listen. Hashem, he meant to tell them, hey, Jews, you know me only as Hashem who made miracles. Yes, you count on me. Look what I did for you. The 10 plagues that I give to Paro. I showed to Paro who I am. I showed you what I can do. I crossed the sea. I'm the Baal HaBayit of the sea. I created the sea. I crossed it for you. You Jews, you only know me as the one who is the Baal HaBayit. Now you're gonna know me, the one who give you laws. Anuchi Hashem, I didn't liberate you from Egypt just for nothing. No. Now let's talk business. Ten Commandments. Anuchi Hashem, you have to believe on me. You have not to steal, not to kill. This is the Ten Commandments. Respect your father and mother. Respect Shabbat. Don't be jealous. That was a kind of the second introduction that Hashem He made to the Bnei Israel. In Egypt, they know Hashem. Only the one who gives miracles. Now tachlis, now conclusion. Oh, what I did for you, it was not just for a fan. Oh, what I did for you, it's to come to a conclusion, theory. That's why Hashem, now he presents himself as a, you know, a lot of times we see the king. We know a lot of times, like David HaMelech, Alav HaShalom. David HaMelech, he was a big fighter. Before he became a king, he was a big fighter. But he was a big fighter. Now it become the king. You know Hashem, they know Hashem. The Jews know Hashem as a fighter. Adonai Shemel Hama, Adonai Shemo. Hashem was a fighter, he fighted Paro. Good. But now, he presents himself now as the king. Now, I choose you not only to be your fighter, your king, but I have Torah to give you. So, that was this second introduction. I am the fighter, now I am the king. But to carry on being your fighter and your king, now let's come to business. Ele ha-mishpatim ha-shem tassim lifem. Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, now that I am their fighter who protect them, I am their king, now I have the Torah to give them and propose them this Torah. What was the first mitzvah and parashat mishpatim that Hashem will give to the Bnei Israel? When you buy a slave, he should not be your slave more than six years. So why the Torah start with this mitzvah? There is so many mitzvot in the Torah. Ele ha-mishpatim. Asher tasim lifneihem, give them Shabbat, Shmita. There is a lot of mitzvot. Why Hashem, he start the mitzvah if you buy a slave? If you buy a slave, he cannot remind you. He cannot remind your slave more than 6 years. I mean, you know, at the time, if somebody stole money and he did not have money to pay what he steal, so the Beit Din, they sell him to be the slave to the one to who he stole money. So that was the punishment, 6 years. And Hashem said, after 6 years, you have to liberate him. So the question is, why? Why does Torah start with this mitzvah? If you buy a Jew, a slave, a Jew, that he cannot pay back his... Why we will not do a collection, donation? Why we have to sell him as a slave? Why we will not collect money for him? Why the Beit Din? They will sell him to be a slave. Let's collect money for him. You know, this week, a lot of times, there is no week that we don't collect money for people that want to get married. We collect money for people who have no money for their... We did collect money to save somebody from jail. A lot of times, we do collect money because if you don't pay a debt, so he will be in jail. So that's what we call pidyon shvoyim. So why we don't do pidyon shvoyim for this man who don't have money to pay his debt? So why we have to send him to be a slave? Why we are not good people? Why Hashem didn't give us the chance to pay for him? No, the Beit Din decide this man. He don't have money, so he owe money to the one to whom he stole or to whom he borrowed money, so we sell him to be safe 6 years. Why? My friend, you must know something. Hashem, he wanted this kind of mitzvah, first, that people will not steal, because people, they may say, well, Jews are Rachmanim, Jews are have good hearts, so they will collect money for me to pay my debt. Hashem, he didn't give a chance for that. Because Hashem, he wants to make sure that people will not steal money. Because if they steal money, they don't have money to pay, the big deal will sell it as a slave. And Hashem, he wanted that every time we remember that we were slaves in Egypt. And we have to be good people. That was the first mitzvah that Hashem gave. After Matan Torah, Hashem gave this mitzvah. Hashem, it was when Hashem appeared to the Jews in the Har Sinai to give them the Torah, the first thing he told them, I'm Hashem who liberated you from Egypt. You were their slaves. And now, after Matan Torah, the first mitzvah that Hashem he gives to the Jews again, I am Hashem who, if you buy a slave, you cannot keep him more than 6 years. Don't forget, you'll be slaves in Egypt. So be nice to that man that you bought as a slave. And don't keep him all his life with you. Only 6 years. No more than 6 years. And after 6 years, send him back home. And don't send him back home empty-handed. Give him money, give him whatever he need. This is very important that Hashem, he wants to remind us, always we talk about the exit of Egypt. And that's why Hashem gave us the first mitzvah. Don't forget. This is another explanation. If you buy yourself to be an Eved, to be a slave for Hashem, there is two kinds of slaves. A slave that a man is a slave of another man, or a man that is a slave of Hashem. Eved Hashem. When you buy yourself as a slave to Hashem, so don't forget, all your life you have to serve Hashem. How can you serve Hashem all your life? Only by feeling that you are the slave of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. So my friend, now you understand the meaning of this parasha. The meaning of this parasha is that the parasha of Mishpatim, it reminds you that you've been a slave of Hashem. That you have to be the slave of Hashem. Don't forget that you've been the slave of Paro, and now you are not anymore the slave of Paro, now you are the slave of Hashem. And that was the introduction that Hashem he did the first time. When Hashem appeared to the Jews, he told them, you know me as a fighter, you know me only as God that did all these miracles for you to liberate you from Egypt. Now you have to know that all what I did for you is to give you the Torah. That was the reason why you went out from Egypt, just to give you the Torah. And now, of course, now after this two introduction, I am your fighter who saved you. I am your Hashem who liberated you from Egypt. I am your king. Now, Hashem is it Moshe Rabbeinu, go to back to business. Propose me the Torah like a Shulchan Aruch. Not to forget that there are only strangers in this world. The same way when you invite a guest, all the kind of food is in the table, the same way when a man should feel in this world, he's only a guest. And what's the purpose is by being in this world to keep Torah mitzvot? I would like to tell you a beautiful story that somebody told me yesterday. Really a fabulous story. Somebody called me from Lyon yesterday And he told me that he was very, very ill. And so the doctors decided that they have to take him to hospital. And he started to pray to Hashem. He told me he prayed so much to Hashem, and he said to Hashem, Hashem, I want to serve you. I want to be your servant. I want to do everything for you, Hashem. But Hashem, please do me a favor. I don't want to go to the hospital. I don't know there what I can catch. I don't know what's going to happen to me there. Please do me a favor, Hashem. I want to wake up tomorrow morning. I want to be cured. I want to be well. I couldn't believe. Bemet, yesterday, was talking to me like that. I was excited to know what it is the end of the story. What is going to tell me? And then he told me, it was making the story long. I told him, please tell me what happened. I'm excited. No, Rabbi, you must listen to me. I said, I don't want to listen to you. I want to know the end. He said, well, I went to bed. After I light the candle of Rabbi Chaim Pinto, I went to bed. And I told my mother and my father, Papa, Be'ezrat Hashem, tomorrow I will be well. Be'ezrat Hashem, you will see, Papa. Well, that's what happened. The morning he woke up, a big nest. He was starving, he wanted to eat. And he started walking. His mother, she told him, you walk? Yes, Mama, I'm starving, I want to eat. Give me something to eat. But are you sure? Are you kidding? No, Mama, I want to eat. So she gave him to eat. And he told his mother, I don't want to go to the hospital, I'm well. No. And the ambulance came as promised, because that was the arrangement, that the ambulance would come the morning. So they forced him to go. The doctor couldn't believe. They checked him. All the day they were checking him, all the doctors around him, he couldn't believe. They find nothing. You see, my friend, this is Eved Hashem. There was another story who show you what it is Eved Hashem. There is a woman. This woman, she has a husband that unfortunately he was paralyzed, and he was he couldn't move, he couldn't talk, just in bed. And his wife, she was a doctor. She had to take care of him, to change him. And sometimes this man, he had some attacks that his wife, she had to take care very much to try to calm him down. If she don't calm him down, he will die. She was exhausted. She was tired. She did not know what to do. And one day, that man, he had a big attack. She said, well, let him die. I can't. I'm young. I'm only 36 years old. I don't have children with him. For 10 years already, he's like that. Let him die. And suddenly, she was thinking, how can I do that? On one hand, she's fed up. I mean, she called the doctors to take care of him. Why she have to be his slave? And then she saw his face. And she told, I have to save him. And she saved him again. And the rabbi, Rabbi Yitzchak Zilberstein Shalita, when he heard this story from her, he told her, Madam, you're a tzaddiket. You are a real woman. You are among those nashim tzadkaniyot. You are among those women tzadkaniyot that you are suffering for 10 years. You are the slave of your husband. And now you had the chance. I mean, if you cannot save him, you cannot save him. And you risk it, your life, because he has so bad panic attack. And with those attack, he could hurt her. But she did everything to save him. So the rabbi told her, so what's going to be the future? All your life, you can miss all your life because of him. So she told him, Rabbi, I am the slave of Hashem. And Hashem put this man in my hand. If I don't help him, who's going to help him? I'm sure if I take him to the hospital, they will let him die there. So I have no choice. This is Torah. This is Torah. My friend, I have to tell you, when Yitro, this is something incredible that I want to tell you. Yitro, when he came to the desert, he sent some people to tell Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe, I arrived from Midian with your wife and your children, and I want you to come to welcome me. Not only you, I want all the Jewish people to come to welcome me. Wow. And okay, if you don't want to come to welcome me, at least people, all the Jewish people, they should come out to welcome your wife. If you think it's not covered for them to welcome your wife, so at least your children. So the big question is, Yitro, do Yitro love kavod? I mean, I don't understand. The Yitro, he love kavod? Yitro, he left all the kavod behind him to join the Jews. And suddenly now, he wants kavod. He's looking for kavod. He's looking for glories, for honors. It's impossible, this. My friend, I explained to Moshe that Yitro, who is a big tzaddik, he did a big effort, a big sacrifice to come to the desert to convert himself. He was a big priest. He was a big priest. Everybody was giving him kavod. He fighted against everybody because everybody were ashamed that Yitro, he changed his religion and he became a Jew. That was terrible for the world. Just imagine a big pop who become a Jew. It will be a dishonor for everybody. So for the rest of the world, Yitro, that represented all the idolatry of the world, he become Jew. That was nobody talked to him. They put him in. He left everything for Hashem. And now he's looking for kavod. Now, Yitro was not looking for kavod. He became so much the slave of Hashem because he left everything behind to become the slave of Hashem. So Yitro said to Moshe, Moshe, I want all the Jewish people to come out to welcome me, not to give him kavod, just to take example from me, to take the example how I left everything behind only for Hashem. And if you think that it's not enough, that it's not right to do that, so at least it can come out to see, to welcome your wife, because your wife, she was my daughter. And your wife, She left everything behind to marry you. If you think that the Jewish people did not need to see that, so at least to see your children, that they came to join the Jewish people, that they didn't stay in Midian. And Hashem was right, and Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Moshe, go, welcome him. Go with all the Jewish people, because this man Yitro, he is a real man, he's a tzaddik. He left everything behind, so it's very important that people will come, they will teach, they will take him as an example. Because the Jewish people, they saw a lot of miracles to become what they are today. But Yitro saw nothing. He saw nothing. I mean, I understand somebody who saw a miracle to become Jew. But Yitro saw nothing. Only he heard. And he was the only one to come to convert himself. So go out. Go from the camp and welcome him. Give him all the honor that he deserves. Because people, they will learn. They will learn from him how to be a good Jew. And that's why, my friend, the parasha of Yitro is named after Yitro. Because Yitro, he did a big Kiddush Hashem. He didn't mean Yitro that the Jews will come to welcome him, to give him glory, to give him kavod. No. He only meant that they will value the Judaism. And they should be proud of their Judaism. Proud to be the slave of Hashem. You know Yitro what he did? He did a big seuda. He invited all the Jews to the seuda. Why this seuda? I mean, if somebody do a seuda to Hodaya because he had a miracle, okay. He do a seuda. But Yitro, he did a seuda for the Jews. Why? What this kind of seuda? What it is? Even Moshe Rabbeinu came to the seuda. Even Moshe Rabbeinu was serving people to eat for the seuda of Yitro. Aaron came. All the Jews came. He did a big seuda for thousands of people. Why this seuda? You know why? He wanted to thank Hashem for what he did to the Jews. Now you understand why Hashem gave him the title of this parasha of Matan Torah. Because the man will think, love your neighbors like yourself. Ve'avtal ha'echa kamocha. And Yitro, he did this seuda to thank Hashem for the miracles that he did for the Jews. I mean, usually, I thank Hashem for the miracles that he does for me, but we don't see people doing a seuda for a miracle that Hashem is doing for other people. No. And Yitro did it. So Hashem, he says, you love Am Yisrael like that. You don't know them. How did he arrive at that level? So Hashem told him, well, there is a lot of to learn from you, Yitro. To be a real Eved Hashem, to be a real slave of Hashem, they have to learn from you. They have to learn from you what you reach by yourself. You didn't reach this level that somebody teach you. You arrived to that high level by yourself. So this is a real introduction for Matan Torah. So there was an introduction of Matan Torah from Yitro, the way he act, the way he behave, and it was an introduction for Matan Torah from Hashem. I am Hashem. I'm not Hashem that you know me in Egypt. Now, I am Hashem, your king. That all what I did for you in Egypt, just to give you the Torah. And now the Parsha Mishpatim is the business. All what I did for you is to serve me. Well, this is the Parasha of the week. Yitro Mishpatim. May Hashem give you bracha, be'etzlacha, be'ut, be'et Hashem, and all what you need, be'et Hashem.